All right, good Tuesday morning, everyone. We are on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange with Jim Cramer to talk about the markets and Bitcoin. Jim, SEC Chair Jake Clayton, urging everyone to exercise caution.
Look, I like that. I think that's part of the job of the SEC is to remind people that some things could be dangerous. Now, I have been saying that the more price discovery we get for Bitcoin, the more regulation or at least warnings we get, the more I like it. So there have been people who say, oh, Jim, you finally came around. No, I am getting what I want to see. Mm. I want to find out where the thing is. And if we get the more futures contracts, the more firms that make the futures, the better. Getting a warning from the SEC so that people know they should do it at their own risk. I do wish that we could find out a little more about who started it. I do think that software can be hacked. I have McAfee on tonight. I'm going to ask them. And I really want people to exercise caution. I am not saying direction. I'm not talking about direction. I am just talking about a deregulated or unregulated market does have issues for me. A lot of people feel that's the advantage of it. It's not an advantage for me.
All right, Jim, moving to tax reform, the Senate bill has that first-in, first-out provision. What does it mean?
Yeah, I was surprised that the Journal finally got on that. I mean, one of the reasons why I think that FANG has struggled here is that if you bought some FANG at 5, you bought some FANG, I'm sorry, let's use Facebook. If you bought some Facebook, because we own that big fractionalers, let's say you bought some at 30 and you bought some at 120. Well, you can pick the lot. But beginning, if this tax bill does go into law, the Senate version, you will have to take the 30. They're not going to let you. They're going to say, what was your first in? You have to sell that. And so why not make your sale now of your and pick your basis? Because you know you're not going to be able to pick that basis after. So you're just going to have to hold it.
So do you think selling now to prepare for this is a good idea?
No, I'm thinking that's okay. What people are doing.
Yeah, it's not good. Okay, meanwhile, Jim, Pepsi.
I like to buy stocks because I like the companies.
Right.
I don't like to be motivated by the tax person, but I always like to, by the tax man, but I always like to know what tax man could be doing to common stocks. And the stocks that are up the most are being the most victimized for now. I think that will stop very soon.
And we'll see if this even makes it into the final bill.
Yeah.
We'll see how it plays out. Meanwhile, Jim, Pepsi ordering 100 Tesla trucks.
You know, it's funny. I was saying that if Pepsi were to go buy some Bitcoin with its cash management, then Bitcoin would fly. The fact is that Tesla, a heavily shorted stock, does get pre-orders from major companies, Walmart, PepsiCo, which tells me they're sampling it. And if they're sampling it these are pre-orders, that's very bullish for Tesla. I'm not a bull nor a bear on Tesla. I kind of take the same view as I have for Bitcoin, which is be careful. But I see good side and I see bad side. And good side is that PepsiCo has ordered 100 of these, pre-ordered 100 of these vehicles.
Or Jim, you have McAfee on tonight. Who else do you have?
I have VMware. Now, if you're an enterprise and you want to get on the cloud, you have to get your on-premise system to be in connection with, say, Amazon Web Services. And the way to do that is to have one big system that you can use on your PC and use in the cloud. But you need someone who can coordinate that and do it for you, and that's VMware.
All right, that's tonight, 6 p.m. Yep. Eastern on CNBC. Jim, thank you so much.
You.
We're going to continue the conversation on actionalertsplus.com.
Yes.
A lot more to talk about, including Comcast.
Absolutely.
Join us there.